In this question, we are given that the velocity time graph of a car and a scooter are shown in figure. Here we can see car first accelerates. This is a velocity time curve. So car first accelerates up to 15 seconds, then moves with a uniform speed of 45 meters per second, and scooter is consistently traveling at 30 meters per second. Now it is asking the difference between the distance traveled by the car and a scooter in 15 seconds and the time at which car will catch up the scooter. That means the time when car will overtake the scooter. So here in solution we can directly write distance traveled by car in 15 second is, this can be written as S car, and as up to 15 second car is accelerating, so we can directly write as half et square. And acceleration of car can be given by the slope of this velocity time curve, so this can also be given as acceleration as 45 by 15 multiplied by t square is 15 square. If you wish, you can also directly calculate the area under velocity time curve, which is half multiplied by 45 multiplied by 15, and that gives us 675 by 2 meter. This is the distance traveled by the car that can be directly obtained by either area or by using half et square. And if we calculate the distance traveled by scooter in 15 second is, this can be given as a scooter, and this we can simply write as VT because scooter is traveling at a uniform speed. So this 30 multiplied by 15, this is 450 meter. So the difference which is asking, which is asked in question, can be given as S scooter minus S car. This 450 minus 675 by 2. On simplifying this, giving us 112.5 meter. So here we can see option C and D both are 112.5 meter. So option A and B can be discarded, and out of C and D we need to check. And here if we carefully see, directly without solving, you can say option D is wrong because it is saying the time when car will catch up the scooter is 15 seconds. That's incorrect, because at 15 second the distance traveled by car is less than that of a scooter. So directly we can write answer to this question is option C. This, by eliminating option D, we are getting that only option C can be the possibly correct answer. If you wish to verify this, then you can consider up to time t, the scooter and car will cover equal distances when car will catch up the scooter. That we can verify. However, directly we can get the answer. That answer is option C. So here to verify, what we can do, if we consider if car catches the scooter at time t, then we use the distance by car at time t should be distance by scooter at time t. So in this situation, up to time t, and here it is quite obvious that t is greater than 15 second. So for t greater than 15 second, distance traveled by car can be written as 675 by 2, which is the distance traveled up to 15 second, plus onward it moves with the uniform speed of 45 meters per second. So this 45 multiplied by t minus 15, and this is equal to the distance traveled by scooter in time t, that is 30 t. So if we simplify this relation, directly you can see here this 45t minus 30t is 15t, and 15t is equals to 675 minus 675 by 2, this is 675 by 2. So simplifying, we are getting the value of t as 22.5 seconds, and here you can see option C is matching. Here I have solved this conceptual analysis just to verify. However, in examination you need to save time, and as I already explained, by eliminating option D you can directly write answer should be option C, because there is no other possible case exists. So directly you can mark and proceed on to other questions in examination. However, sometimes if this is the only part which is asked, at what time the distance traveled by car and a scooter are equal, we follow it with this concept. So you need to be careful for such cases.